Hey everyone, and welcome to Boston Auto Blog. I don't normally make a video like this, but seeing as though I am the owner of a Volkswagen GTI, and I can use this platform to spread awareness, I figured why not create a video and topic about this. I think it'd be really good to maybe have a centralized video, seeing as though no one's really talking about it at all. I know a number of owners are trying to reach out to Car and Driver, Jalopnik, and a lot of other bigger magazines to try getting them to talk about the issues that Volkswagen is having with GTIs, but also GLIs as well. Now, recently, I have seen a number of people complain about the stalling issues for their GTIs. Now, because I'm an owner of a Rabbit Edition, I'm seeing that more, the Rabbit Edition, more than any other trims. However, this is across the board. This is not have anything to do with just the Rabbit Editions. This is the S, SE, and Autobahn trims. But I think it's really centered around the 6-speed manual transmission. Now, a number of people saying that the DSG is involved as well. Now, I have done some research. I've taken some polls on this. There appears to be maybe a 1 in 8 chance that DSGs are going to have this problem. Some owners that I know have the Rabbit Edition, they've put 5,000, 7,000, 10,000 miles on them, and they're seeing no problems at all. When it comes to the 6-speed manual transmission, there's a lot of issues. The car is stalling on them, and it is not user error. So I figured, why not get into this video, talk about what's going on, what are the solutions, what are the theories, and see what is going on with Volkswagen, and what are they doing to rectify the situation. And so, without wasting any further time, let's get right into this video. Now, if you guys have been on Reddit, especially the Golf GTI Reddit forums, there is a subreddit or a topic specifically for the 6-speed manual transmission. Now, again, this does affect DSGs, but not to the same frequency. I really think that DSGs are okay right now. I don't think that there's going to be major problems with them, but people have reported some stalling issues with that. Now, I have printed out what is going on. Someone has really highlighted everything that's going on with these cars. There have been over 110 confirmed cases that have been reported to the NHTSA. A lot of people are complaining about this. They're not happy about it. And from what I'm understanding and what I'm hearing, especially from my group of Rabbit owners, that Volkswagen is buying these cars back. That there really is no solution to this problem. From what I hear, Volkswagen is buying them back, no problem. It appears that they're even telling the dealerships to not even work on the cars at all. This is how bad the problem is, at least with the 6-speed manual. I don't know what it's like with DSG. Again, from what I'm understanding with the DSG, there doesn't seem to be any problems. I haven't had any problems. So for me, I'm not concerned, at least not right now, but that could be something that might change in the future. So I'm looking at the possible solutions to the problem. Some people think it's the intake camshaft. They're looking at the camshaft valve component by replacing it. Some people think it's also the oil that's being poured into this car. Now, it actually got me thinking here. We're in the middle of a heat wave, and it appears that when it's hot out, that the cars stall. I'm thinking maybe the oil is thinning out at hotter temperatures. One of the issues that I have been facing, and one thing I thought was rather concerning, was the fact that my GTI is putting out 224 temperature for the oil. And I'm thinking, that's kind of high for a stock GTI. And I started getting concerned when I was listening to a guy at a Cars and Coffee talk about his 940 wheel horsepower Camaro, and that his oil temperatures are somewhere around 900 to 910. And I'm thinking, if he's got a car that's that modified, and his oil temperatures are below that, maybe that's a possible issue. Now, I really want to see how this car runs over the next 2 days. For a high temperature, it's going to be 100 degrees, probably a lot warmer than that with humidity. So I want to see how this car runs. I'll let you guys know what is going on. You can follow me on Instagram at BostonAutoBlog, and I'll give updates on that. But there definitely seems to be a connection between hot temperatures and the car stalling. And I've noticed that with a few owners, they bought their cars in the winter, and all of a sudden, now they're having the issues, whereas people who just bought the cars are having issues immediately. So I'm thinking as temperature related, but there's a lot of theories, and I don't really want to be the one that just throws out a theory, which is really not the problem. Now, for some of the solutions, at least the short-term solutions, there appears to be a complete overhaul of the ECUs. Now, from what I hear, and I'm not a mechanic, and I'm not a GTI or Volkswagen enthusiast on this, that we got different ECUs for the 2019 model year. That everything prior to 2019, at least for the Mark 7s, they had the older ECUs, we have new ECUs. I think that that has something to do with the fact that we're being used as guinea pigs. I mean, rightfully so, but we're being used as guinea pigs for the Mark 8 generation. The Mark 8 generation is going to be a little different. It's going to have probably a different ECU. It's going to have more horsepower. And I think it's going to have a little bit more different components. Probably the reason why we got a 7-speed DSG from the Golf R for this year. So I'm thinking that Volkswagen is doing a lot of testing with the 2018 model year heading into for the 2020 to make sure the Mark 8 is perfect. But as a result, I think we're dealing with a lot of problems. So the ECUs being a minor solution, but some people report that it's not doing anything at all. And as a result, the car is being bought back by Volkswagen. Even the dealerships are buying them back with really no hassle at all. The people don't have to go to lemon laws. The car is just being bought back. And to me, it doesn't really create a lot of confidence in the car. I think that there is a problem with it. I don't know for the DSGs, of course, but for at least the 6-speed manuals, it appears there really isn't a solution here. Now, also a number of buyers are reporting that the car is in transport mode. Now, I've heard about this before. The cars are being in transport mode. That's really due to the fact that they don't want the battery to die during transport to dealerships. A lot of people are able to override that through VAGCOM or OBD11. And some people are having great success with that, but it appears that that's not the problem. So, from what I hear, it's really back to the camshaft. Some people are saying that the camshaft does not end properly, that the angle is off. I just think it maybe has something to do with oil related, but I don't really know. I am not going to speculate on that, but there just definitely seems to be a problem. And I wanted to really bring this up. A lot of car buyers, especially GTI owners that have a 2018 model year, have messaged me saying that they're having a lot of problem and they're surprised that I'm not having problems yet. Now, I can say for certain that 1,100 miles in, I have not stalled once. Mostly, if it's a DSG, I may not have this problem. It may not arise for another 4,000, 5,000 miles. But it is a problem that a lot of consumers want me to talk about, and I think that with my platform, I can use this for good. Now, I also want to say this is not just a GTI issue. GLIs are not in the clear here. Now, what I've also seen, it is not a DSG problem. It is a 6-speed manual transmission for the GLIs. What I'm trying to figure out here for myself, and just trying to get down to the bottom of this, is why are the DSGs not experiencing the same problems at the same frequency as a 6-speed manual transmission? Because we're using the exact same oil, we have the exact same ECUs, we have the exact same components. So there's definitely an issue with the 6-speed manual transmission. And I mean, I've done research on this. For the DSGs, at least for the GTIs, this is not something just for the 2018 model year. This has happened for Mark 7 GTIs in the past. Again, not the same frequency. Not everyone is experiencing this problem. So for me, it gives me a little bit of assurance being the owner of a DSG, but across the board, there definitely seems to be a problem. What's also disconcerting is the fact that all these cars are not stalling at the same time. Some people are reporting the stalling to happen around 3,000 miles. Some are reporting them on the day they got the car. So there really seems to be an issue that's with the car, and it doesn't arise all at the same time. It seems to be for certain models, it might arise later on down the road. Now, some people are trying to pinpoint what models are the problem, because some of the later models for the 2018 model year are not having this issue. Now, mine was made in February of 2019, so maybe that's part of the issue here, where maybe I'm not dealing with that stalling issue. But we'll just have to wait and see over the long term. Now, I'm going to keep you guys updated over the next few days. As I said before, we are in the middle of a heat wave. So if this car is going to stall, it would be this weekend, with it being 2 days of 100 degree temperatures. The problem I'm going to have here is that with a DSG, it's kind of hard to replicate the stalling issue. For people with manual transmissions, they don't have any problem trying to replicate it, because from what I hear, all they need to do is roll up to a stoplight and the car will stall, especially after being on a highway. From what I understand, if they push the car on the highway and they start getting into stop-and-go traffic, that's when the car stalls. Now, for me, I am primarily highway driving, but I drove pretty hard in the car yesterday and then was in stop-and-go traffic, and I don't see any issues. Now, some people think for the DSG it has something to do with the eco mode, which could definitely be the issue, especially where it has auto start stop feature. Now, I turn that off. I may even go through VAGCOM or OBD11 to really override the system and turn that off completely, because that may be part of the issue. Now, for 6-speed manuals, I don't know what the issue is would be with that, because they don't have an auto start stop feature. So maybe it's the ECU, maybe it's the oil, who knows what it is. I don't think it's a transmission, just because I think everyone's dealing with this issue, but there's definitely something going on here, definitely a problem. I'm definitely going to keep you guys updated, but for me, my issue is going to be the fact that I can't replicate the stalling. So for 6-speed manuals, it's very easy for them. They take the service manager with them, and it's very easy to show them, and then they hook it up to a through the OBD. And unfortunately, there is no check engine light. So there's no, like, the car isn't memorizing this issue. So it doesn't show up on the on when they plug it in. So that's kind of a concern as well. But once again, I'm going to keep you guys updated and let you guys know what's going on. From what I've seen for 6-speed manuals, it's a 50-50 split with people who are dealing with this issue. So not everyone's dealing with it right now, and it's not happening all at the same time. So that's something to keep an eye out. But for me, for DSG, 1 in 8 chances. If I was to go a little further out, maybe 2 in 10. Maybe that's the exact same percentage. I'm awful at math. But it seems like I have a better chance of not seeing this problem arise. But it's definitely something to keep my eye on and really see what happens over the next few days. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more. Also, share this video. There is no one out there talking about this right now. There have been a few owners that have posted the video, but they're not at least trying to talk about it or bring any type of awareness to this. I think this is very important. The fact that Volkswagen is buying back the cars, they even told a person that Germany does not have a fix. So there definitely seems to be a problem. If your car is stalling, definitely go in, check it out. Tell the service managers to check the Reddit forums. It is well documented. There are a number of forums talking about this, and there definitely seems to be a well documented history over the last, I'd say, 6 months. So guys, definitely share this video. Even use this video for when you walk into a dealership if there is a problem. They say they have not seen this problem. It's not the dealership's problem. This is not the dealership's fault. I don't blame them in any way, shape, or form. They have no idea this is going on. The brand itself is becoming aware of it through the 110 cases. I think it's now up to 120 cases that have been reported on NHTCA. So Volkswagen is definitely aware of it, but they have no fix for it. So they're just buying the cars back. So definitely keep your eye on this. It could definitely grow over the next few months, especially where now our cars are going to start having more mileage on them. So maybe we're all going to have this issue. But for right now, DSGs, I wouldn't be concerned, at least right now. But for the summertime, especially where the oil could thin out, maybe we're going to start seeing that issue. So definitely keep your eyes on that. It's a real issue. It really is. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more. And I'll see you guys next time.